Hello students, so today we are going to do 10th standard question bank of probability. Let's see the first one. Which of the following cannot be the probability? The answer is B, 1.5, because the property of a probability is this: 0 less than or equal to P less than or equal to 1. So what is the meaning of this? Is for a particular event, your probability can be 0, it can be 1, and it can be anything from 0 to 1. So it cannot be less than 0, nor it cannot be more than 1. Okay, so the next one is, the formula for probability is Na upon Ns. So probability is given as 1 upon 2, Na is 5, and Ns we have to find out. So when I cross multiply, I get Ns equals to 10. That is A. Next, when a die is thrown, so when you throw a single die, there are total 6 outcomes. Next, in how many ways a card can be drawn from a pack of well shuffled playing cards? It is total 52 cards are there. Okay, next is an important MCQ, students. What is the probability of an event that a number chosen from 1 to 50 is a prime number? So total outcomes are 50, and from 1 to 50, if you count all the prime numbers, so there are going to be 15 prime numbers. So when I reduce by 5, I get 5 threes are, 5 tens are. So my answer is 3 upon 10, option A. Okay, let's see the next one. Which of the following shows the highest probability? So what you can do is, let us convert everything in form of decimal. So if I divide 4 by 5, I get 0.8. B is already 0.83. 58% means it will be 0.58, and 1 upon 2 is 0.5. So after I convert into decimal, let me decide which is the biggest one. That is 0.83. Okay, so make sure that you first convert into decimal and then decide which is big. Next, when a die is thrown, the number of sample points, okay, when two dies are thrown, so the number of sample point is always 36. There are 36 outcomes. Okay, now let us see the next question. Now what I have done is, students, for few questions I have already done the solutions, okay, so that we can finish the video fast. Let's see the first one. Write a sample space if two coins are tossed. See the first one, students. Okay, two coins are tossed. So when two coins are tossed, the sample space is what? HH, HT, TH, and TT. And the total number of outcomes are 4. NS equals to 4. You have to just write down the sample space. Okay. Next, write a sample space when a die is thrown. When one die is thrown, what is the sample space? S equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And NS is total outcomes is 6. Okay. Next, in a set of 25 cards, each card bears only one number from 1 to 25. One card is drawn at random. Write down the sample space. So first you have to write down one card is drawn from a set of 25 cards. The sample space is all numbers from 1 to 25. Okay. And students, for writing the sample space, you have marks. So don't write 1, 2, 3, 4, ... 25. Okay? Yes, you have to write down all the numbers. Let's see the next one. Fourth sum. Two-digit number is formed with the digits 2, 3, and 5 without repetition. Write down the sample space. See the fourth sum. First, see the numbers what I've crossed, 22, 33 and 55. These are the numbers which are not to be taken because they have specified here, okay, that repetition is not allowed, without repetition. Okay, if they don't specify, yes, then you can include all these numbers in the sample space. Okay, otherwise, no. So without repetition, we are writing all the remaining numbers. That is 23, 25, 32, 35, 52 and 53. So the total outcomes are 6. NS equals to 6. Next is, write the event in a set from the following random experiment. If one die is thrown, write the number obtained on the upper face is even. So whenever we want to write any event, first you have to write down the sample space. When one die is tossed, okay, what are the outcomes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, NS is 6. Now from here we want an event for even number. So you have to specify this statement. Let A be the event of getting an even number. Okay, this statement also carries half mark. Then write down A equals to 2, 4, 6. Here it is even number. They can ask for prime numbers, odd numbers, or whatever. But that event has to be specified. Okay, yes. Let's see the next one. It is an activity. One die is rolled. So we know there are total 6 outcomes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And event A is prime number. Okay, so out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, what are prime numbers? 2, 3, and 5. So here I'm writing 2, 3, and 5. Now, let me give you a small note, students. Always remember this. The number 1 is neither prime nor composite. So when they say prime number or composite number, the number 1 is not to be included in any of these. Okay, yes. So let us come back to the sum. So A is 2, 3, 5, the number of outcomes is 3, and we know the formula for PA equal to NA upon NS, that is 3 by 6, and when I reduce I get 1 upon 2. Very easy sum. Okay, but make sure that you don't take 1 here. 1 is not a prime number. And obviously, nor it is a composite number. Let's see the next one. 2 coins are tossed simultaneously. We have to write down the sample space. Okay. Here, the brackets are not printed properly. So, let me write over here. S equals to, okay, HH, HT, TH, and TT. Okay. So, according to the question, the bracket, the box is here and here. So we wrote here. The next is, A is an event to get at least 1 head. Okay, let me put a bracket here. There is no bracket here. Okay, so A equals to bracket at least 1 head. Now what do you mean by at least 1 head? Okay, so let me just convert this particular statement in Hindi so that you will understand it very properly. At least 1 matlab kya, kam se kam 1 head or usse zyada, means I want 1 head or more than 1 head in event A. Okay, so they have already taken HH, TH is already there, so what is missing is HT. Okay, so HH, HT, and TH, and event B is getting no head. Okay, so let me write here properly. Event B is getting no head. No head means what? I want only tail in the outcome, so that is TT. Okay, let's see the next one. A card is drawn from a pack of well shuffled playing cards. Now remember one thing, students, for any sum based on playing cards, you're not supposed to write down the sample space. You have to just directly write down NS equals to 52. Okay, yes, directly this, no sample space for that, number of sample space directly. Okay, now find the probability that the card drawn is red in color. So we have 2 patterns which are red in color, that is 13 of hearts and 13 of diamonds. So total there are 26 red cards. The next step is the formula NA upon NS, that is 26 upon 25, that is 1 upon 2. Okay, let's see the next one. In Adarsh High School, out of 30 students in a class, 3 students wear spectacles. So there are, out of 30, 3 students are wearing spectacles. And the question is, you have to find the probability that a student wears spectacles. Simple. There are total 30 students, so the number of sample space is 30. We want a student who wears spectacles, so there are total 3 students wearing spectacles. Formula is NA upon NS. So probability is 3 upon 30. That is 1 upon 10. Okay. Now, a small note. Okay. If the question slightly, if they say find the probability of students not wearing spectacles. Okay, let me take that as event B, not wearing spectacles. So what will you do? Total there are 30 students, out of which 3 are wearing spectacles. So how many are not wearing? 27. Okay, 27. But so 27 upon 30 will be the probability. So 3 9s are 3 10s are. So the probability is 9 upon 10. Okay, a slightly different sum. Okay, let's see the next one. A card is drawn from a pack of well-shuffled card. Now again, if you see, okay, I've done the sum. So we are not writing the sample space. I'm directly writing a card is drawn from a pack of 52 playing cards. So N is equals to 52. Find the probability that the card drawn is spade. Okay, so spade, there are total 13 cards of spade. So NA equal to 13. And we know the formula for probability. That is NA upon NS. That is 13 upon total 52. After I reduce, I get 1 upon 4. Okay. Let's see the next one. Two coins are tossed. So when two coins are tossed, there are total 4 outcomes. HH, HT, TH and TT. Number of sample spaces 4. Find the probability of event getting head on both the coins. So I want only head in the on the first coin as well as on the second coin. So A is HH, NA is equal to 1 and probability is equals to 1 upon 4. Okay, total number of outcome is 1 upon 4. Okay, let's see the next one. The third sum, that is what I've done on the extreme left side. One die is rolled, then find the probability of an event that the number on the upper face is greater than 6. Now we know that when one die is thrown or tossed or rolled, okay, there are total 6 outcomes, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, if you see, we have to specify the event, let A or B or C, whatever. Let A be the event of getting a number greater than 6. We know that there is no number greater than 6. So A equal to empty set, okay, just open and close the bracket. So NA equal to 0 and probability is 0 upon 6, that is 0. Okay, next, a very typical sum of 3 coins are tossed. So do it very properly. 3 coins are tossed, so we know that there are total 8 outcomes. Okay, so out of 8 outcomes, what we want, find the probability of an event of getting no head. No head means what? I don't want H anywhere, so I have only one option, that is TTT. Okay, so A is TTT, so the number of outcomes for event A is 1, so probability is 1 upon 8. Okay, now let's see the fifth one. There are 30 cards in a box, each bearing numbers from 1 to 30. One card is drawn at random. You have to find the probability that the number is a multiple of 5. Okay, so we have to find an event from the sample space. So make sure that you write down all the 30 numbers. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 30, because you have to find an event A from here itself. Okay, so we want multiples of 5. So in short, we want table of 5 up to 30. So that is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. So there are total 6, NA equal to 6. So probability is 6 upon 30. If I reduce, I get 1 upon 5. Okay. Let's see the next one. Again in activity, question 3. A box contains 5 strawberry chocolates, 6 coffee chocolates, and 2 peppermint chocolates. So total there are 5 plus 6 plus 2. Total there are 13 chocolates. So NS is equals to 13. Now the next is, find an event A that it is a coffee chocolate. So if you see, there are total how many coffee chocolates? 6 coffee chocolates. So the formula is NA upon NS. So probability is 6 upon 13. Event B is for peppermint. Okay, so if you see, there are total 2 peppermint chocolates. So NB equals to 2. formula is NB upon NS, that is 2 upon 13. Okay, simple activity, very easy. Okay, now let's see the next one. A very important question, students. Two dice are rolled. Okay, this is a very important question. Okay, they can ask probability of any event, but two dice are rolled. Two dice are tossed or rolled. Okay, so when two dice are rolled, we have total how many outcomes? 36 outcomes, starting from 1, 1. The last number is 6, 6. 1, 1 to 6, 6. Okay, the next, the event is the sum of the digits on the uppermost face is at least 10. Now, what do you mean by at least 10? Let us understand that. Okay, at least 10. At least 10 means what? I want 10 or more than 10. So that is 10, 11, 12, 13, and so on. But what we see is the sum cannot be 13 because the last number is 6, 6, addition is 12. So I want a pair, I want all the pairs whose addition should be 10, 11, 12. So that is event A, 4, 6. 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 4, 6, 5, and 6, 6. There are total 6 pairs. So the probability is 6 upon 36, that is 1 upon 6. Okay. Let's see the next one. Event B, that is the sum of the digits on the upper face is 33, which is not possible because the biggest sum is 6, 6, that is 12. You cannot get a sum more than 12. Okay, so NB equal to 0 and probability is equal to 0. Okay, let's see the next one. 3 coins are tossed, an important sum. Okay, so 3 coins are tossed. We know that there are total 8 outcomes, so NS equals to 8. Event A is what? Of getting no heads. No heads means I want only tails, so that is TTT. So NA equal to 1, probability of A is 1 upon 8. Simple. Now event B is getting at least 2 heads. So what do you mean by at least 2 heads? Means I should get 2 heads or more than that, and more than that we have maximum 3 heads over here. So I am going to write down all the outcomes where I get 2 heads or more than 2 heads. So I wrote HHH, 3 heads, then HHT, again 2 heads, HTH, again 2 heads, and THH, again 2 heads. So total outcomes are 4, probability is 4 upon 8, that is 1 upon 2. Okay. Students, the next sum is very important. Okay. This is one of its kind. One coin and one die are thrown simultaneously. So we should know what is the sample space. So when I'm writing H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6 means what? Head on the coin and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the die. And similarly, I'm writing T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. That is tail on the coin and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the die. So these are the possible outcomes what we can have. So NS is equals to 12. Let us see event A. To get a tail and an even number. So I want T, an even number. So that is T2, T4, T6. 3 outcomes. 3 upon 12. 1 upon 4. Let's see event B. Getting a head and an odd number. So H1, H3, H5. Again we have 3 outcomes. Probability is again 3 upon 12. That is 1 upon 4. Okay, so here the sample space is very important. We should know how do we write down the sample space when one coin and one die is thrown. Okay, let's see the next one. There are total 3 colors of balloon, 2 red, 3 blue and 4 green. So total is 4 plus 3 plus 2, 9. So NS is going to be 9, but you have to write down the sample space. R1, R2 for red, B1, B2, B3 for blue, and G1, G2, G3, G4 for green. So what is the probability that Pranali gets a red color ball? So there are 2 red color balls, balloons, sorry. So that is 2 upon 9. The next is she gets blue color balloon. So blue is how much? 3. So B1, B2, B3. So 3 upon 9, that is 1 upon 3. Okay. Yes. Now we come to the next question, students. Very, very important. Yes. This is definitely board sum. Let us do this sum. Okay. What is the probability that an ordinary year has 53 Sundays? So when I say ordinary year, ordinary year means what? I'm talking about 365 days. Okay, so what I'm doing is, for your understanding, let me do 365 divided by 7. Why 7? I'll tell you. 7 5s are 35, 1 5, 7 2s are 14, 1. So can I say that 365 days means 52 weeks plus 1 day, that is nothing but the remainder. Okay, so when I say there are 52 weeks, means what? There are 52 Sundays, 52 Mondays, 52 all the days. So when I write the sample space, I'm going to write down the sample space for this 1 day. Jo 1 day extra hai yahan par, I'm going to write down the sample space for that. So that 1 day could be what? It could be any 1 day of the week. So it could be Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. It could be any 1 day. So what is the total number of sample space? 7. Okay, obviously 7 days of a week, 7. Now what is the question? We want 53 Sundays. So let A be the event, we have to write down that. Okay, so A, what I want? Sunday. From the sample space, Sunday I wrote. So NA is how much? 1. There is only one outcome. So the probability is NA upon NS, that is 1 upon 7. So this is the probability for 53 Sundays in a normal year. Okay, same question again. Now I have to solve the sum for a leap year. Now we are doing the similar calculations for leap year. So let me write here leap year. So leap year means how much? 366 days. So when I divide 366 by 7, 7 5s are 35, 1 6 2s are 14, I get 2 year. So what does that mean? That means 366 days equal to 52 weeks plus 2 days. Yes, so here what we're doing, here we are writing the sample space for 2 days. So how do we write down the sample space for 2 days? Let's see. Now when I say 2 days, means what? The last 2 days. So now the last 2 days or any 2 days are always going to be the consecutive days, like Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday. You cannot have Monday and Wednesday, you cannot have Sunday and Friday. Okay, yes, so it, these are all consecutive days. So see what I'm writing in sample space in bracket. Sunday, Monday is one group, then Monday, Tuesday is one group, then Tuesday, Wednesday is one group, then Wednesday, Thursday is one group, then Thursday, Friday is one group, then Friday, Saturday is one, and last is Saturday, Sunday. So we wrote all the possible outcomes for last 2 days, and what we see is NS is 7. Now what we want? Sundays. So where we can see Sundays here? Let's see. So it can be Sunday, Monday, or it can be Saturday, Sunday. Okay, so the last 2 days can be Saturday, Sunday, or Sunday, Monday. So event A I have two required outcomes, that is Sunday, Monday, and Saturday, Sunday. So NA is 2. So probability of A, when we are talking about 53 Sundays in a leap year, is 2/7. Okay, so always remember this. For a normal year, or we say ordinary year, it is 1/7, and if it is a leap year, it is 2/7. Very important, some students. Okay, let's see the next one. Okay, I've already done this particular sum. Okay, in a box contains 36 cards, so there are total 36 cards. So I'm writing all the numbers from 1 to 36. Again, don't miss out anything. We have to write down all the numbers, okay, because we have to write events from here. Okay, so let us see the first event, a complete square number. So let me give you a note here. Okay, remember this. One, the number one is always a perfect square. Okay, remember this. So when they say perfect square, you should start with one. Means obviously number one should be there in sample space. Okay, so it is 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, and 36. Total outcomes is 6. So probability is 6/36. Let me write here 36. Okay, let me just reduce this. So it is NA equals to TA equals to 6/36, that is 1/6. Okay. So don't forget to write down 1. 1 is always a perfect square number. Okay. Next is a prime number. Again, we know what are prime numbers. Okay. We are not going to start from 1. 1 is not a prime nor composite. Remember, I told you before. Yes. So apart from 1, what are all other prime numbers up to 36? I have written 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, and 31. So there are total 11. And probability is 11/36. Okay. The next is a number divisible by 3. Okay. So a number divisible by 3 means what? We have to write down table of 3 up to 36. You have to see the sample space. Okay. So 3, 6, 9, I'm writing up to 36. So total there are 12 outcomes. So probability is 12/36. That is 1/3. Okay. Let's see the next one. The first one. Let me show you the first one first. Second one I've already done. Okay. Now here what they have given. The first sum I'll do here. A bag contains white balls and some blue balls. Okay, so white balls are 5. Blue balls we don't know, we'll take it as x. So total, how many balls are there? 5 plus x. So that is going to be the total outcomes. N is equals to 5 plus x. Now if the probability of drawing a blue ball is double that of white ball. Okay, now see what they give you. Probability of blue is double that of white. Okay, now see probability of blue. How many blue balls are there? X. So what is the formula for probability? NB upon NS. So X upon 5 plus X. 2 into what is the probability of white? 5 upon means the required upon total 5 plus X. Okay. Now here we have the same denominator, so 5 plus x, 5 plus x will cancel, and what we get is over here is x equals to 10. So what is that? That is nothing but the number of blue balls. The number of blue balls is 10. Okay, and that is what you do find out. Okay. Now the next sum is again an important sum, students, from problem set. Understand this. Now again we have similar type of sum like a die, but here the numbers are not from 1 to 6, the numbers are from 0 to 5. Yes. So what we write is the same thing how we write in two dies, but we start from 0, 0. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, and the last number is going to be 5, 5. Now the question is, you have to find the probability that the product of the digits of the upper face is zero. Okay, so what I have highlighted with blue. Okay, yes, so these are the pairs. When you multiply, you get zero. Okay, and what is the property that when two numbers you multiply, you get zero? One of the number should be zero, or both the numbers should be zero. So we are taking all those numbers where we have zero, so the product is going to be zero. So we have total 11 such numbers, so the probability is 11/36. Okay, the next sum, an important sum, students, a missing helicopter sum. Okay, now, okay, find the probability that it is crashed inside a lake. Okay, so this particular part is lake. I'll just highlight with yellow. This is the lake part, and the other part is going to be the land part. Okay, so we have to find the probability of. So the probability that it, what we say, crashes, okay, in a lake is, so what is the probability required upon total? Here, what is required? This area is required. We want the helicopter to crash in a lake. So area of lake upon total area. Okay, area of lake upon total area. Now let's see the figure, students. This side is 4.5, this side is 2. So this particular part, that is the breadth of the lake, is going to be 4.5 minus 2, that is 2.5 what, meters. Okay, next, this is 9 and this is 6, so the length of the lake is going to be 9 minus 6, that is 3 meters. So the area of lake is going to be 3 into 2.5 upon the total area. So when I say total area, means what? I'm going to take the whole area, which includes lake also, that is the area of the whole rectangle, that is again length into breadth, that is 4.5 into 9. Let us remove the decimal on both the places, numerator and denominator. Pass. The sum is over. What we have to do is just reduce this. 1s are 3s are 5, 5s are 5, 9s are. So my final answer is 5/27. This is the probability that it will crash in a lake. Okay. Okay. Let's see the next two sums. These are the last two sums, students. The fourth sum. Okay. The fourth sum is important. Three horses A, B, C are in a race. Now see what they're given. A is twice as likely to win as B, and B is twice as likely to win as C. So what we'll do? Let us take the probability of C as X. Okay. And what they have given, see, I'm showing with the highlight. B is twice as likely as C. Means what? The probability of B is twice of C. I'll take it as 2x. Now, see what I'm highlighting in pink. A is twice as likely as B. Means probability of A is twice of B, and B is 2x, so that is 4x. So these are the probabilities. The question is, what are their individual probabilities? Okay, now one property what you have to remember is, for this sum, when I add all the probabilities here, that is equals to 1. Okay, so that is 4x plus 2x plus x equals to 1, 7x equals to 1, so that will give me x equals to 1/7. Now what we have to do, we have to just substitute the value. So probability of C is x, so that is 1/7. Probability of B is 2x, so that is 2 into 1/7, that is 2/7. And probability of A is 4x, so that is 4/7. Okay, so this is how we got probabilities of all. Okay, now Let's see the fifth sum, last sum. Okay, now in the last sum, students, there is a small correction. Okay, this number should not be 8. Okay, because if I do the calculations, I'll show you the calculations. What you can do is you can try the same calculations with 8. You won't get a proper answer, an appropriate answer. Okay, so what I've done is I just changed this number. Instead of 8, I'm taking this as 10. Okay, yes. So where the mistake will be, I'll tell you when I'll solve. Okay, so a bag contains 10 red balls and some blue balls. So I'm taking red as 10 and blue as x. So total is going to be 10 plus x. So that is nothing but ns. Total outcomes are x plus 10 or 10 plus x. Now what they have given is the probability of drawing a red ball to a blue ball is 5/2. Means what? Probability of red upon probability of blue is 5/2. Okay, this is what is given. So just to make the calculations easy, probability of red, what I'm doing is I'm just shifting probability of blue on this side. Okay, so 5/2 into probability of blue. So this is 5/2 as it is. Now probability of red, probability means what? Required upon total. Okay, how much required red? Total, how many red balls are there? 10 upon the total is 10 plus x. Okay, and here we have probability of blue. How many blue balls are there? X, and the total is 10 plus x. Okay, so what will happen, students? Again, if you see here, the denominators are same, so this will cancel. So what we get is 10 equals to 5/2 into x. Okay, 5/2 into x. Let me take the screen down. So what I'll get, x equals to 10 into 2/5. Okay, now just see what I told you in the question. Actually, they have given there are total 8 red balls. So if I substitute here 8, what I'll get? 8 into 2/5, which is 16/5. What is that? X. What is x? Number of blue balls. Now you cannot have the number of outcomes, but the number of blue balls or red balls in decimals. I cannot have 16/5 number of balls. Okay, so that is why the number 8 was wrong. So I just took a number, a random number, which is divisible by 5. You can take 20 also. Okay, so it is 1s, 2s. So what we got is 4. Okay, now I'll just do it on the left side. So now I have how many red balls? Just a minute. Now I have how many red balls? 10. How many blue balls? 4. So I have total of how many? 14. Okay, total is of 14. Now what is the question asked? Let's see. You have to find the probability of drawing a blue ball. So probability of blue ball is NB upon NS, that is 4/14, that is 2 2s, 2 7s, 2/7.